Switching gears now, budding Filipino artists across the Philippines will be featured in a series of concerts that will be held by Malacañang. According to the palace, Concierto sa Palacio was initiated by the President Marcos himself. The first concert will be held tomorrow, April 22. To tell us more about the program, we now have its creative consultant, Chris Villalobos. Good morning, Chris. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning, ma'am. Thank you so much for having me, and good morning to everyone tuning in.
All right, our pleasure. So first off, when did this idea come to be? Why a concert?
I think definitely, I think we all know that at the height of the pandemic, the creative industries was the one of the industries that was badly hit, struck, and affected for a couple of years after recovering also. And I think this is also our president's way to show the importance of the creative industries and also a way for us to showcase new talents that are not necessarily in Metro Manila or mainstream parts of the country.
All right. And Chris, who are you in partnership with for this initiative? Any organizations you're partnering with?
Yes, there are actually four offices that came together to make this show possible. Of course, there's the Office of the President, there's the Presidential Communications Office, there's the Social Secretary's Office, and the Presidential Broadcast Staff, Radio Television Malacañang, or what we call RTVM.
Right, all hands on deck. Now, this is to highlight the nation's rich culture and a world-class talent, right? What kind of performances can we expect to see?
Yes, ma'am. I think we always expect that whenever you perform at Malacañang, it's either you are a classical or a cultural performer. But this time, we are opening the doors and possibilities to many kinds of talents. So for this one, we actually have, of course, we have a choir, and we also have our powerhouse vocalists, but we also have rappers. We have spoken word artist, and then we also have two harpists and harp makers that hail from Cebu. So all of this is possible, and we are hoping that since this is a series of concerts, when we move on to the next one, which hopefully will happen in the next 3 months, we are opening this all up to, we hope that we have movement artists. We're expecting beatbox artists, since that's becoming a craze also now. And it's also a way for us to showcase our own talents here in the Philippines. You know, if wherever we see talent shows all over the world and they fly over Filipino talent, then why can't we showcase them here?
Right, and pretty diverse from traditional to modern performances, right? So who will be invited to these, and how does one go about actually attending them? Is it open to the public or by invitation?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, this is kind of a two-sided affair, because aside from also showcasing the young talents, there will always be a sector, a community, or a group that we pay tribute to. And in this one, we call it Concierto sa Palacio, Awit ng Magiting. Since we celebrated Araw ng Kagitingan on April 9, we thought, what better way than to pay tribute to the men and women of the armed forces of the Philippines? So 400 members of the AFP, along with their families, will be watching the show live with the President and the First Lady on the Malacañang grounds. But of course, this is definitely accessible to the public by live stream on our Facebook pages, RTVM, OPGovPH, and of course, the Bongbong Marcos page. And we would also like to thank everybody who has been following the Facebook page of Concierto sa Palacio. And I believe we also have a TikTok.
All right. But since we already established the creative industry and how the pandemic affected it, how important is it that the creative industry makes a comeback as the nation takes leaps of progress towards economic recovery?
I think it's common knowledge that the Filipinos are known for their talent. And of course, we have that all over the world. Thankfully, we are grateful that performing artists during the pandemic were able to find ways and resources to be able to communicate and showcase their talents online and virtually. And we think that definitely the creative industries has to come back and has to make a recovery. And I believe it is.
And this event is helping us do that, right? And Chris, what else will we be seeing in the event? Any other activities lined up?
Right now, the program is pretty short and prepared already. It's all set. It should run for about an hour and 30 minutes. So you will be able to see featured videos about our artists, as well as other special guests that will be attending, that will be performing in the show.
Right, lastly, before we let you go, invite us to the series of concert. When and where will they be happening? We know that they'll be available to see online. Will they be happening simultaneously?
Yes, all of this will be happening tomorrow on April 22, Saturday at 6:30 p.m. This is called Concerto sa Palasyo, Awit ng Magiting, a tribute to the men and women of the Armed Forces of the Philippines. And of course, the general public will not be able to go to Malacañang grounds itself. This is not a ticketed event as well, but we are definitely accessible through our live stream Facebook pages, which is RTVM, OPGovPH, and the Bongbong Marcos Facebook page. And this show was made possible by actually four offices. We have the Office of the President, we have the Presidential Communications Office, we have the Social Secretary's Office, as well as the Presidential Broadcast Staff, Radio Television Malacañang, or what we call RTVM. So we hope we see all of you live stream tomorrow at 6:30.
All right, all exciting things ahead. Thank you so much for speaking to us this morning. It's been a pleasure, Chris. Break a leg.
Thank you.